This is gonna be weirder than usual. Can't be helped. You called me. So here I am. I know I shut you out sometimes. I'm always glad to hear from you. It's just that I get my hopes up. So many times it's led to nothing. I found nothing. It's like we live in a room and there's a poster on the wall.
Turns out it's on mute.
We stare at it and we think that's the whole world. The room and the poster. The picture is something nice. A landscape, a famous person. Like in that movie, what is it called? The prison movie. The room's a cell, and the picture, it's different for each of us. It can be beautiful or terrible, but we're all transfixed. But it's all a lie. Something to distract us from the truth. They're lying to us. We're lying to ourselves. The room's not the world. The world is much bigger and much stranger. There's a hole hidden behind that poster that leads to the real world. We all feel safe in that room. But sometimes something crawls out from behind the poster. And the ones that see it happen freak out and try to forget what they saw. I'm here. Why did you bring me here?
Hello? Anyone here?
Okay, why is my sound gone? Why is that not picking up my controller? Okay, mouse and keyboard it is. Synonyms are not allowed inside the bureau. Recent incidents have issued a reminder of programs, advice, weapons, pages, laptops, smartwatches, smartphones, smart gaming devices, anything smart. I'm taking a screenshot of that. Anything smart. I need to turn sensitivity down on this mouse. Jesus Christ. Okay, the software hadn't kicked in properly. That's why.
This seal. I saw it a long time ago. I keep seeing it in my dreams,
data center initiative, construction, office equipment, janitor cost, mold removal. Page 5.
Federal Bureau of Control. All these years, I've been looking for them, and they were hiding in plain sight.
Permission to the following basic protocol: shoot to kill. That's always something you want to read. Shoot to kill. Story of my life. As usual, no man. The R4 reports are due by the end of the week. We're still waiting for them from a number of people. If you need an extension, please request form R4.E from your supervisor. If you think you're exempt from filing an R4, you'll need to get written permission from your department. R4 is mandatory under section 75.2. Blah, 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 blah.
Hello? Hey, excuse me.
There you are. You are here about the job. Janitor's assistant. You need to go to the interview. Go that way to the elevator.
Thanks. Elevator that way. Got it.
Very good. I'm Ahti, the janitor, by the way. You'll work for me. You can say I sent you. If they don't hire you, you are no element. There be work for the axe. Take them behind the sound when you come out.
I've done enough night shift loner jobs to know it makes us come off weird. Ahti the janitor is a friendly face in my book.
Better than somebody with no face at all. Think about it. No face.
Wait a second to it. Lobby, start working, blah blah blah. So, is this not the way I came in? Was there another entrance? If so, that elevator wasn't there before. The elevator is.
The cell and the poster. I was 11 years old the first time I saw behind the poster. They told me I imagined it. I've been trying to pull it down ever since. Will you help? Did I lose you there for a moment? You know what's on my mind. My baby brother, Dylan. 17 years since the men of this bureau took him.
We get in if lockdown is like that. Until my appointments for the rest of the week, I can
Shit. You want me to pick it up? The murder weapon? Really? And there goes the poster.
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWE's altered world events, intrusions upon the perceived reality. Now, The service weapon is, of course, a prime example of an OOP, a very powerful one. Ingrained in the Bureau's DNA, a key component in our prime candidate program. Come out of that Russian roulette a winner and you, you're it.
Look at this place. Where am I? The same gun. Okay. Now I have a gun.
Let's put that back.
Something's coming. This threat. An attack. Duty as director. Keep the Bureau safe.
Did you hear that? It's the dead man. Right after the pyramid spoke to me, and it was just noise, and I understood every word. And this gun's alive. You know what? I'm happy. Happy to be here. Things have quieted down outside. Is it safe to go?
That looks like the opposite is safe.
You can't let this happen. You can't let this happen. You can't let this happen.
You can't let this happen. You can't let this happen. You can't let this happen. You can't let this happen. You stopped it. You. Oh, thank you. That was horror.
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWE's altered world events, intrusions upon the perceived reality. A side note, remember to cover their connection to the astral plane as well. Now, the service weapon is, of course, a prime example of an OOP, a very powerful one. Ingrained in the Bureau's DNA, a key component in our prime candidate program. Come out of that Russian roulette a winner and you, you're it. Lose and you're, well, fired. Thank you. I'm Dr. Darling, head of research, Federal Bureau of Control.
Sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss burrowing into everything.
this place. Is the Hiss your enemy? Alright, it's our enemy. That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over.
That went well.
Sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss burrowing into everything in this place. Is the hiss your enemy? All right, it's our enemy. That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over. Cleanse the control point. What does that mean? Help me fix it. Holy shit! You did it! We did it!
Hello. Can you hear me? Are you with us? With the Bureau? Are you still sane? Please, talk to me. We saw you deal with the compromised agents.
Can't tell you how happy I am to talk to somebody sane.
The feeling's mutual. Yeah, I'm Pope, Emily Pope, Dr. Darling's assistant.
My turn. Should I lie?
Jesse Faden. I'm just visiting.
I should have lied.
Oh, shit. You're the new director. Hold on. We're coming out.
Director Faden.
Call me Jesse.
Okay, Jesse. I'm Emily. Look, somehow, this hostile force, this...
hiss?
That works? Somehow the hiss managed to infiltrate the building without any warning.
And just like that, my name for it is official. The hiss. Like the sound of poison gas leaking in.
We're in full lockdown. It seems to have spread everywhere and to everyone not protected by an HRA. And, extraordinarily, you. You are the director, and that makes you special by definition. Trench is no longer the director, obviously. I'm sorry, I'm talking too much. This whole situation is just a lot.
Trench is dead. Shot. Ah. I found his body. And the gun.
Do I tell her it looked like a suicide?
The service weapon.
Also, and this can sound crazy, but he keeps appearing to me, saying things. It's hard to make out, but he told me to cleanse the control point, push the hiss out. The whole room shifted around.
You did that? And you entered the building when it was already in the lockdown, before you became the new director? How?
I'm not ready to tell her about you yet.
A janitor let me in.
I love it. This is fucking unbelievable. It's... I can't even... look, Jesse, I have a million questions, and you probably have a million more.
Like, do you know my brother Dylan? Not yet.
But there's something I need to ask you to do first. If you can cleanse a control point, then you can maybe cure those infected or possessed by the hiss. Because if that's possible, our options are very different.
Emily Pope. I don't know her, but I like her already. She's the opposite of the faceless agency I've blamed for what happened to me for so long. But I can't trust her yet. Or rather, the Bureau she's a part of.
Yes. I can try.
I'm speaking for you, of course. We can try it together. Okay. You with me? We did it before. Push the hiss out.
Assuming you can hear me over the loud noises.
The hiss has burrowed too deep. Ripping it out. Rips them apart.
Jesse, over here.
I can't cleanse them.
I saw. It was worth a shot. Thank you, Director. Jesse.
I'm gonna tell her why I'm here. I'll risk it.
Listen. The Bureau was involved in an incident in my hometown, Ordinary, 17 years ago. The Bureau came in and covered the whole thing up. I've been looking for this place for a long time.
That's enough. Maybe that's too much already. I can't tell her about Dylan and the rest yet.
I've seen mentions of an altered world event case dealing with Ordinary. You were at Ground Zero as a child?
Nice.
It was one of the big
ones. You being alright?
And before my time. And very classified. I can try to dig out some old files for you. My boss, Casper Darling, would know, but he's missing. I think he knew this was coming, or suspected. He came up with the HRAs, the Hadron Resonance Amplifiers. I think they're what saved us. Or a few of us. And Director Trench would know.
Trench? The ghost, or whatever he is. He mentioned something called the Hotline. Said I should find it.
It's another object of power, like the gun. An old Bakelite telephone. A direct line of communication between the director and the board. Maybe he can talk to you more clearly through that. I mean, Trench has years and years of experience. He might know how to destroy the hiss.
Where is the hotline?
It's kept in the communications department through the mailroom. It's part of this sector, so we can access it even with the lockdown in place. We'll get the door open for you.
Okay, that's my next stop.
That's Tomasi's department. He's the head of communications. I don't think he had an HRA. He kind of made a point about not wearing one earlier. Keep an eye out.
They call me the director. But that's not me. I'm not a director type. I'm not a leader.
Why am I here? I think you already know. Yes, I came for my brother, but there are other reasons, too. I said I was looking for answers, but I might never understand them. I'm not looking for proof. This is already it. More than enough. No matter what they told me all those years, I know it's real now. I didn't imagine this. I want to be a part of this world. What scares me shitless is that I finally found it. Only to see the hiss destroy it all.
I know I'm only at the beginning, but yeah, I'm really enjoying it.
The door to the comms department is just outside the boardroom back in the lobby. They should have gotten it open by now. Follow the signs to the mailroom. You can get to the hotline containment chamber through there.
Again, a welcome message.
You will have to put up with my bad shooting, though.
overpowering heroes. I don't want you to know.
Good choice, me.
There it is again. A welcome message. Overpowering here. You don't want me anywhere near it. With you on that.
Baby, baby, you're just so.
8 inches wide and capable of storing a whopping 80 kilobytes. Stolen by our friends at the CIA, the disk held the launch codes to Soviet nukes. This is not the disk, of course, but one exactly like it, a perfect fusion of concepts vibrating in the Cold War era collective unconscious. A receptacle. It is a receptacle for dangerous energies to hone in on, and they did. We don't have the details, but when things started flying around the disk, it was transferred to us. It's an object of power. OOP. Oops. Oh, and it can launch things telekinetically through the air. To date, we've launched maybe 3 dozen pencils. And once, we even launched a cup.
Lensing time.
Communications. We're on the right track.
That wasn't creepy. Nuh-uh. So after clearing this, that's shelter now open. Thank you.
Moving on.
Object of power. Looks like the Hiss have latched onto it. We need to cleanse it.
Oh, Jesus. No.
It's harder to hear you when I'm here. It's like the channel's been changed. The board's in charge here. They're pyramids in the Bureau seal. Are they really the ones pulling the strings? I'm not their director. I'm no one's director.
Okay.
There you are. You were gone. Cut off. I got it. Just like you wanted, right? This will help me fight the hiss.
What? Where the fuck did you come from? Jesus Christ. Spinny wheels. Spinny wheels.
Emily said that the hotline can be reached through the mailroom.
You are the kind of person who distorts your happiness, Clarice. Like Ross, the yellow and red AI. Through a mirror inverted in real life, we endure in
thank you.
Stepping George.
But you forget this happens more often.
Listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years.
This must open the door.
Thank you.
Indeed. I like how it keeps collectibles when you die.
I have a feeling he'll be back. Let's stay focused. The hotline should be past the mailroom.
But cool. I noticed you could throw anything, but I didn't think you just walk up to the wall and just grab.
All right, take this down. The situation in Cuba has been evaluated by the relevant authorities. The mysterious illness affecting the staff at the U.S. Embassy in Havana was caused by sonic weaponry in the hands of a foreign power. Numerous personnel have damage to the inner ear, but most are expected to make a full recovery. Of course, the I can't blame that on some stupid noise gun. Thank God no local doctors examined them first. Honestly, what are the odds an altered item would show up inside of the U.S.?
The hotline can't be far now.
All right, take this down.
Been here before? No. I've stayed at a lot of roadside motels across the country, on the road, on the run, under the radar. This feels like all of them, like something recognized from a dream.
Back to the Black Pyramid. No one mentioned puzzles to me. You say that, but I'm dense. Okay. Maybe.
The key has a black pyramid on it.
Look at that, I'm a genius. Okay, so that was just part one. Oh, pull them and freeze. Got it. Okay. I'm guessing someone just like freeze. Watch where I'm going.
It is a phone. It's an object of power. It doesn't connect to any typical network. A direct line to the astral plane and the board. And my hypothesis is, under the right conditions, to other planes of existence as well.
A director needs a team. My management team. These people know the secrets of the Bureau as well as I do. Some even better. Darling, Tomasi, Salvador, Marshall. Marshall especially, my head of operations. She sees right through me. She knows I don't like relying on people. The only person you should fail is yourself. But things change when you become director.
I have it. The hotline. I can reach Trench. Well, listen to him. He feels more like an echo. An echo with... important info. I need to get back to Emily. People react strongly when I tell them about you. Is it too soon to tell Emily? She might be able to help.
That wasn't interactable before.
It's a long time to learn how to stabilize the control points, the ley lines, the meridians of the oldest house. Darling found a way to soothe this beast. We discovered we must cleanse control points of all interference. It's my duty as the director, like Northmoor before me. I couldn't manage it in my own house, at my home. I'll damn well do it here. Without the control points, the oldest house would swallow us alive. We'd be sealed inside an endless labyrinth. No one would hear our screams. If an enemy ever managed to corrupt the control points, it'd be over fast, spreading like a cancer, leaping over the fire breaks like a crown of fire. They are the weak point. Darling's right about that. He's wrong about everything else. Dangerously wrong. Suspiciously wrong. Has he been compromised? I can hear the hotline ringing in my dreams, constantly ringing. Ringing so loud I can't hear the voice I'm straining to understand. Why don't I pick up? It's a secure line of communication with the board. They would tell me what I need to know. Do I fear their answers? Would they have warned me of this threat? I didn't see it coming. A traitor in our midst. A conspiracy plotted right behind me. I can't trust anyone. I must assume all my intel has been manipulated. The hotline is the only channel I can trust. Bind it. Control it. The rule and the ritual with objects of power. It can't be tampered with.
Ring, ring.
Jesse, did you get the hotline? I mean, how is it out there? The comms? The hiss? Sorry. You made it. I'm glad.
Emily? Let's talk.
Of course.
I got the hotline. I can make out what Trench is saying now.
Incredible. What did he say?
He talked about his management team. People who knew the Bureau's secrets. Your boss, Darling. Tomasi, but he's gone. He is gone. Salvador?
He's the head of security.
And Marshall?
Helen Marshall is head of operations. She's tough, ex-CIA. She took her Rangers and went to the research sector to secure the HRA production. She hasn't come back.
Someone who could help us. The other sectors. How do I get there?
It's impossible because of the internal lockdown. You can perform a directorial override to lift it, but that can only be done in the maintenance sector. Normally, you take the sector elevator down there. It connects all the sectors, but it won't work while the lockdown is in effect.
We already got past one lockdown. Maybe I can find a way.
Jesse, look, with no prep, no training, in this extreme situation, you are doing phenomenally well. And all that and the hiss can't seem to affect you. I mean, I would love to run some tests on you. If... you agree, that is. We could find out something that would help us.
Tests? I don't know. She might find out about you. But I wouldn't mind understanding more myself.
Okay. If you think it will help. Great. I'll check the internal documentation for any lockdown bypasses. We need to get these sectors open to locate Darling and Marshall.
And I'll look for a way inside the maintenance sector. The sooner we find one, the sooner I reach this override.
I want to know more about the janitor. Points? What?
I can hear the hotline ringing in my dreams, constantly ringing, ringing so loud I can't hear the A director needs a team, my management team. The Ocean View Motel and Casino is a familiar friend to me. I stayed in countless motels like it while investigating AWEs across the country, back in my field.
Do you hear that?
Sounds like it's coming from the elevator.
A live specimen.
Here? Facilities.
Whoops. Didn't mean to do melee damage.
Maybe we can bring in an observation unit from the containment.
I'll put in a...
Request with Pope.
The hiss are tampering with it some. Hi, Jesse.
Thanks, Emily. I'm sure I'll have more questions soon.
Just let me know.
Can we change one of the controls? That's enough.
Pope wants us to get a field lab set up as soon as possible.
With what? We can't get any equipment from the research sector until we turn the lockdowns.
We'll see what we can find around here.
Time to work. Meet me in the main de Nanas.
Like I said before, the janitor is a friendly face.
Is it?
The maintenance sector is the janitor domain. If I can find Ati here, he can help me reach the override. Maybe it was you who got me into the oldest house with the lockdown on. Maybe it was Ati. It felt like he made the elevator appear that took me to Trench's office. Is Ati guiding me too? Directorial override is right there, in the control room. How do we get there?
I don't think I have spin mode.
What's down that way?
Well done. You got the job. It's place for congratulations. Yippee, Satana. It happened in the last drop. I truly need an assistant.
Funny thing is, I've been a janitor. I'm more at home in that role than as the director. Only Ati here seems to see that.
Yeah, hi, Ati. Look, we need to get the lockdown lifted, otherwise I can't get to the other sectors. Can you help me get to the override?
Yes, yes. Easy peasy. It's just around the corner. But first, we need to get you working. Very small couple of hours job.
Something tells me it's gonna be more than that.
You think there's a dog buried in this? I can tell you are not yesterday's grouse's son. That's why you'll make a great assistant. Very well. I'll hit the facts on the table. I'm gonna sanon perkele suoraan, that this house has a vermin problem. A bad one. They've already messed up the cooling pumps. And the power generators of a power plant, perkele. And the pensioner inside. He's starting to feel the band around his head tighten. The situation needs to be fixed before the plant blows up. And we all disappear like a fart in Sahara.
Trying my best to keep up with this. Fix the coolant pumps and the power generators, otherwise the power plant will blow.
But don't you worry. I've left you clear instructions. You'll catch the end of the thread before I go to my vacation. The works on the dashboard here, you can do later, when you have time.
Vacation? Right.
Yes, no one's gonna cancel my holiday or seat's gonna rattle. But don't worry at all. You'll take care of it and soon this crisis gonna be last winter snow. You better go now, so you don't have to run with your head as your third leg. The door in the back leads to the plant.
The door in the back. That's great. Thank you, Ati.
Yep. Burn the dress. Throw it in the fire. Burn it into a reindeer. Not into a reindeer.
This makes me nauseous. An object of power. How do you think it got down here? A carousel horse. Why is kid stuff always so creepy?
Thank you.
see the hiss keep up with me now.
Drawing the pyramid.
The what?
The pyramid.
What's a pyramid?
The black pyramid. It's in the astral plane.
Airplane?
Astral plane. It's big, white, and empty. Or is it? It's a weird, crazy alien dimension. The white goes on forever. You can get lost in all that white and never find your way back home.
I miss my home.
Thank you.
same? No, there it is. I do like that there's an infinite sprint on this.
Are you new? Go talk with Chief Arish in the security booth. He's in charge here.
Ma'am! Hey! Chief Arish, FBC Security. Shouldn't you be in a safe room?
They all have HRAs. We're on the same side.
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm here to perform the directorial override to get the lockdown lifted.
Yeah. Chief Arish, FBC Security. I'm just... Oh, hang on. You're the new director. It's a pleasure, ma'am.
Let's skip the formalities, please.
Right. Faden, ma'am. Look, as you can probably tell, it's a bit of a shit show down here. We've been holding our ground, but whatever's gotten into our buddies has them wrecking the coolant pumps and the power converters. The NSC keeps overheating, and my crews keep getting shot before they have a chance to make any repairs.
NSC?
Oh, sorry. Bureau jargon. It's what we call the power plant. You know, the big rumbling metal thing? Salvador, head of security, asked me to protect it in case of an attack. See, what's inside is dangerous. Dr. Darling seemed to know it would be a target.
Darling? He's here?
No, he came down a few days ago, before everything went to hell. He was out of it. Smelled like a bar mat. He was ranting about vulnerabilities and how he only had one large-scale HRA, but that he needed it somewhere else. Still, at least he gave us these personal HRAs before he left. Hey, did I mention that he was tearing his clothes off? Crazy dude.
Darling knew the hiss was coming.
Listen, I love playing 20 questions as much as the next guy, but we have got to get the water and electrical systems repaired before this baby blows. I'll have my guys unlock the doors out of here for you.
I'll take care of it. You stay and keep the hiss away from the plant if you can.
The hiss? That's what we're calling him? Well, that's catchy. Oh, listen, the radios aren't working, so if you find my boss Salvador out there, could you please ask him what the plan is? I'm sure he will have one by now.
I'll keep an eye out for him.
He sure has a lot of faith in his boss.
Try to stay alive.
Yoink.
Blockages.
Director Faden.
And pipes. The clock back. Now? Oh man, how do you see it?
So I can see if it's going to die again.
Okay.
Whoops. Oh, I see what I meant to do.
Did Ati mean barrels full of hazardous? Seems like I'm breaking some environmental regulations on waste disposal, but if that's what Ati wants, then I'll get it done. Hold together a little longer.
fix it fast. If the plant goes boom, we can throw the spoon in the core. My old enemy, the blocker, is blocking the pipes. You need to leave. He is very clever. His trying to sneak in. We got him caught with his hand in the fist.
Ow.
What the hell is that? Oh, that's the most disgusting thing I've ever seen.
to fix this thing ASAP.
Minor details.
For the pipes? Nothing more satisfying than manual labor.
Oh God. Why did they give people miniguns? Told me they locked on. Yeah. Not sure how I feel about this gun yet. So, engine repairs or central maintenance.
I don't like that sound.
Thank you.
It's fried up. You'll need to fix it before the old epic freezes inside the fridges.
Did I miss somewhere? Probably. Yes.
Now we won't blow up. Let's go lift the lockdown.
Thank you.
forces contain a lockdown can only be lifted by a directorial override.
This is what we came here to do.
Got my bearings back.
Push the fear to the surface and the wet and wet. What before we do you
That's it. The other sector should be open now. I think it's time I told Emily why I'm here. I'll risk it. You two should get to know each other.
Jesse, you made it! And you lifted the internal...
Listen, Emily. Screw it. Just tell her. I haven't been completely honest. I have a younger brother. Dylan. When we were kids, we found an old slide projector in Ordinary's landfill. The slides created... doorways to other places. Bad things happened.
came through. That's all she gets. The rest stays locked inside. But we found help. Through one of the doorways, we met something. A being.
A being? What kind of being?
It's hard to describe, but it... She helped us. We managed to turn the projector off. The bad things that came through the doorways were gone. After that, your people came. Tried to grab us. I ran away. They got Dylan.
I left him behind.
Bureau agents took your brother?
Yes. He covered it up. No one believed me. I just want to find Dylan. I've been looking for him ever since.
What happened to the slide projector? It sounds like another object of power.
I thought you took it. The Bureau. Along with Dylan.
I've never heard of it. But around here, I assume everything's classified. You know, I looked into the ordinary AWE case files after you mentioned it. Trench and Darling were both involved. A large area of the containment sector was reserved for it. The case hasn't been active for a long time. I have no idea if anything's still there. Can you tell me more about this being you found?
Let's hope you two get along.
She's been with me ever since Ordinary. In my head. She led me to you. I call her Polaris.
As in, a guiding star. Did Polaris know about the hiss? If she got you in here, in spite of the lockdown, she's very powerful. Which may help explain your test results. Your readings are incredible, Jesse. Now, cross-referencing them with the database, I found two matches in Darling's old classified files. Unfortunately, I can't access them beyond the file codes. But one was P6, referring to a prime candidate for a potential future bureau director. This was logged years ago.
Dylan. Is that Dylan?
The other match is on something called Hedron, which must be connected to these Hedron Resonance amplifiers somehow. All I know is that Marshall went to the research sector to secure the HRA production after the HIS first attacked.
So, Marshall seems like our best lead on Dylan.
I need to go after her. How can I get to the research sector?
Use my key card. The sector elevator will take you there.
Marshall is the next step. What Emily told me about Ordinary, my powers being connected to things in the Bureau's past. I am so close to something. Do you feel it? Something's coming.
We take turns to come for a visit. I helped you. You owe me now. And when time comes, I will come calling.
Hope has asked us to document the HIS implementation, as she calls it.
Yes, please.
You mean like in person?
In person. with a pencil and paper. I think she's trying to get us killed.
Nostalgia department.
I heard the Hiss attack the power plant. Brings up a lot of new questions.
Research.
Are they communicating? Are they coordinating? What about the plant attracting them?
The power plant is largely confidential. No use guessing the Hiss's motives if...
That went well. Does that stay as failed? Okay, interesting.
Stepping Johnny.
I definitely saw a body run that way. In the toilet. Thank you.
Processing. Sector data.
Just read this. Welcome to the Ranger Field Training Course. The course must be completed in the specified amount of time. When you're ready to start, press the button. Is that all, or?
I always did love obstacle courses.
Get ready, Ranger. Course starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go.
Wrong door.
Guessing this isn't usually part of the course. It's protecting itself. I need to hit it harder to break that shield.
That went well. Good job, me.
Thank you.
Oh, bugger.
Time to have a shield.
Later. Which one? I don't think I can go that way yet. Ow. Stop blinking at me. Okay, I really don't like that. They blink and follow you. That's not what I signed up for.
Thank you. She's in trouble. I need to reach her.
Let's just pretend I didn't see that.
Similar to an iceberg, what you see is not what you always get. Regardless, this place is vitally important to the Bureau. Most information on the Astro... But we can talk in broad strokes. Keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them. Justice. Now, the white non-justice, the ever-present, inverted. An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then, one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions, apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement, native species, always in the distance, and yet, contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astronauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fugue, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
Keep that thing here. Doing with that thing.
That could have gone better.
Someone answer, damn it! We need backup down here.
Marshall, are you still there?
Shit. We're so close. We need to hurry.
Marshall, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm coming to help.
Faden? Hold on. I'm sending the elevator for you. We need to talk.
She got that right.
More of you? Really?
Marshall is right down
there you are. I was starting to worry. Congratulations on your appointment, Director Faden. I'm Helen Marshall, head of Bureau Operations. Zachariah is dead then, and I assume you found his gun.
Just call me Jesse. Trench told me to find you. He said you could help.
And he told you this through the hotline. Makes sense.
None of this fazes her? Really?
Here's the situation. Darling created the HRAs in a lab nearby. We need more if we're gonna survive this attack. My Rangers can't secure the lab alone, not against those things. We need more firepower.
At least she seems to know what's going on here. She could know about Dylan.
I can clear out the hiss. I'll be your firepower.
That's a good answer.
Is she testing me?
Darling has systems in place to protect his labs. This should help you get past them. We'll talk more after you clear out the hiss. Rangers, let her through. We'll have to lock the door behind you. Sorry, but we can't risk a breach.
Seen that funky mirror they're studying down the hall? I heard it steals your soul.
Don't worry. We've already sold yours, but we're even.
Rangers over there. We have to help them.
Oh, I can check out the club.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm gonna stop there for now. See you guys around. Bye.